Hey everybody, it's Pastor David from Walden Community Church. Hey, I just wanted to run a hypothetical for you, okay? Tell me what you think. We got two women in a car. They're gonna go to Walmart to buy groceries. And as they circle, they only have to circle half a turn, and the lady who's driving finds a parking space right in front. And when she pulls in, turns off the car, she closes her eyes, looks up and says, "Thank you, God." The woman sitting next to her says, "What was that all about?" And the first woman who's driving says, "Well, right before we pulled in, I prayed that God would find us a really good parking space." And now the second woman is thinking to herself, "I've been praying for 3 years to have a baby." What do you do with a God who answers prayers for parking spaces and not the prayers of mothers who pray to have a child? What do you do with a God who seems to answer some people's prayers and not others? What do you do with a God who seems to answer some prayers that seem small and insignificant, and to ignore larger prayers that seem impactful and that would help lives? A while back, before we moved to Walden, my wife and I, we lived in California, and my wife, Joanna, she used to work at a little tiny stationery boutique, and I worked at Disneyland. Yeah, I worked at Disneyland. I was a ride operator in Fantasyland, so I made the carousel move, and I worked Dumbo and Snow White. And so during that time, my wife and I lived in a back bedroom in my mother-in-law's house. My wife and I slept on an air mattress for over a year, and my son, my little baby son, slept in the same room as us that whole time. And it was during that time that we were both looking for a career, looking for a job. I was sending out applications, trying to find an answer to this prayer: what am I going to do with my life? And it was during that same time that my wife, Joanna, she started really looking into the story of Noah and Noah's Ark. And it was during that year that Joanna just came to this conclusion that, you know, sometimes you're in the ark. Sometimes you're in the ark. And you really want an answer to prayer. You really want to find land. You really want to find safety. You really want to end this nightmare. And you don't know what's taking so long. But yet, you're in the ark. And you're safe. You're being cared for. You're being watched. Your provisions are being met. And outside, you don't want to go outside. It's raining. There's a storm. There's thunder. God has a perfect time. God has a perfect time to answer your prayer. He has perfect timing. You know, we as Americans, we're not really good on waiting. We don't like waiting. In fact, we kind of see waiting as a failure. If you get in the wrong line, you say, "Ugh, I always get in the wrong line," right? Or if you're going down the freeway and you're behind a slow driver, you say, "Ugh, I'm always behind these guys," right? "I'm always behind these slow people." And we can't stand waiting. We're so impatient. We don't even like food that takes a minute in the microwave. We want it faster. We want everything right away. And if we have to wait or we have to slow down, we look at it as some sort of bad thing. It's a bad thing to wait. It's a bad thing to be patient. It's a bad thing to wait for something. So when we have to wait for God, I think we still make that same connection, that we think this is a bad thing. You know, God hasn't answered my prayer. This is a bad thing. God isn't listening to me. This must be a bad thing. Something bad is going on. Maybe I'm being punished. Maybe God isn't listening to me. Maybe I'm in a timeout or something. And we think that patience, really? We think that patience is bad, that waiting is bad. God is always trying to teach us patience. Patience for the right time. Patience for the perfect time. We're going to talk about that this Sunday at Walden Church. We're going to talk about patience and us waiting on the Lord, us waiting for the right time for Him to answer our most important prayers. We have two services on Sunday. We have one at 9:30, which is our traditional service, and then we have a second service at 11, which is our contemporary service with our worship band, and we have a full children and youth program at that time too. Hey, I'll see you guys Sunday.